Hello everyone, Tony Lee Glenn here again, and I'm doing a new review of Dragon Naturally Speaking version 12, and I'm not particularly paying much attention to what it's doing on the screen behind me. I'm going to see if accuracy has changed. Actually, I know that it has. I thought I'd just let you see how it translates my Southern Appalachian accent again and see if it's actually a little bit more accurate than version 11.5 period. I've been using Dragon Naturally Speaking now pretty much, I would say, 3 or 4 times a week, mostly for blogging because it's much less hassle to put your thought process down and then go back and edit it after the fact than it is to sit there and try to type it in. At least it is for me. I'm not one of the best typists, period. And I like to just go ahead and let the thought process flow, particularly when I'm doing a blog. And also for my YouTube videos, when I'm doing descriptions and things for my YouTube videos, when I'm doing keyword lists, period. The keyword lists really are something that's kind of boring, and you just have to put a lot of commas after those and just start listing them out. For instance, if I were doing a keyword list for this video, comma, I would probably say Dragon Naturally Speaking, comma, version 12, comma, Tony Lee Glenn, comma, review, comma, software, comma, voice recognition, comma, update, comma, tutorial, comma, analysis, comma, period. New line, new paragraph. Looks like the software is doing really well. I get a lot of criticism from YouTube people who do not like my accent, and I can't really change it very much. I guess I could, but I choose not to. I am a Southern Appalachian Highland guy and proud of that, and so I'm not going to go and try to change the way I speak. And so this software allows me to very naturally pronounce my words the way I've grown up speaking, the way everyone knows me out in the world. Period. New line. One of the things that is very helpful for a YouTube video would be having your transcription on there. It helps people to understand what your video is about and to find the keywords. It's good for closed captioning for the hearing impaired. And so YouTube itself does a terrible job of transcribing my accent. The Dragon Naturally Speaking actually does a very good job, so it should be something that I use a lot. I guess every time I do a YouTube video, I should have this headpiece on, and I should be speaking the words so that I can add the transcription into the YouTube video. This can very much help with the search engines. I'm here to say today that I think Dragon Naturally Speaking just gets better and better. I give it an opportunity to analyze my emails and to analyze my Word documents and things that I work in. And by going through and looking at those documents, it looks at words that I use and puts those into a vocabulary so that it knows what I'm saying when I say CCHS, for instance. That would be an acronym for a hospital system that I work for. So this is very useful. I've not looked at this behind me to see how well it did, but you know, for me, if it gets 90% accuracy, just straight out of what comes off my mouth, I can go back and edit that and make it workable for me and save myself a lot of time. So if you're doing blogging, if you're doing YouTube videos and would like to have those transcribed so that your YouTube videos are more searchable, then I would highly recommend having Dragon Naturally Speaking. Now, some other people may have responded. I think some other people have responded with other software packages that do a good job. To me, this one does the best. I've not used all of them, but I have used, you know, various different ones. And for the money, a very affordable program, Dragon Naturally Speaking. I'm using the professional version, number 12. Hopefully this has helped. Let me know what you think of the videos. Let me know if you have any questions. Now, one thing I will say, I'm not what you would call a power user of Dragon Naturally Speaking. I don't usually open up programs and things with it and tell it to highlight this or give it a whole lot of alternate commands. Typically, I'm just letting it translate text for me, listen to my voice, and put those text statements that come out of my mouth at random out onto the page. So that's what I use it for. It's simple text for me. It's a very powerful program, and there are thousands of things it can do. One of the things that I do like is the fact that it even catches my ums and ahs and strange little inflections. And sometimes it actually looks over those pretty well. I mean, I'm able to go back and edit them out easily after the fact. So that's what I'm going to do with this video blog that I've done here. I'm going to take a look at what Dragon has done, seeing how it has understood or misunderstood the words that I've said. As I've spoken very naturally to you, I've not tried to speak in any kind of stilted sort of language. And let's see how well it's done. Then I'll post that online and along with the transcription. I'd just like to see how is version 12 stacking up versus version 11.5. Thanks. Bye-bye.